Assalamu alaikum, boys and girls, and welcome to the Children's Majlis program, where we will be learning about the Battle of Karbala and the Day of Ashura and the events that led up to this very important and very sad day. We will take a look at the amazing personalities that played a significant role in this battle and the important lessons they left behind for us to learn from and to use in our everyday life. The agenda for each day will consist of a recitation and presentation of Hadith-e-Kissa, followed by a recitation and presentation of Surah An-Nas. We will then move on to the Majalis, followed by Matam, and we will end the program with the Ziyarat. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Shall I tell you about the event of the Kissa? The event of the Prophet Kissa. He went to the house of his daughter Fatima and he asked for the Yemeni Kissa. She covered him with the Yemeni Kissa. They shone with the full moon soon after some mother came to join him. Do you want to know who? Then came her son and greeted his mother. As-salamu alayki ya umma. I can smell the nice smell of my grandfather. So he joined him under the kissa. Then came Hussein and greeted his mother. As-salamu alayki ya umma. I can smell the nice smell of my grandfather. So he joined him under the kissa. Then came Ali Amir al-Mu'min, As-salamu alayki, Jinn of Jannah, you are queen. I can smell the nice smell of my cousin brother. So he also went to the kissa. Then Fatima went real close to the kissa and said, As-salamu alayki. Come, O Father, you give me permission to now enter. Yes, you do enter under the kissa. When all five were gathered under the kissa, Jibreel spoke up and said, O Allah, who are these luminous personalities lying under the kissa? He said they were the family of Fatima, husband, sons, and father. They are the ones who are perfectly purified. They are the Ahl al-Kissa, the Ahl al-Bayt of Tahira. They are the Ahl al-Kissa, the Ahl al-Bayt of Tahira. Salawat.
Salamu alaikum, boys and girls, and welcome to Understanding Hadith-e-Kissa, Day 8 of the Children's Majlis program. Now that we have finished listening to the recitation of the Hadith-e-Kissa, we can now move on to our discussion for today. Let us begin our discussion by doing a recap of what we have learned so far. Girls and boys, this first point you all should know very well by now, and that is the Hadith-e-Kissa is recited at the beginning of each Majlis program, and when we recite it, the angels come and surround our gathering and only leave when the entire Majlis program is over. These angels are also praying for our forgiveness. This second point you should also know very well by now, and that is in Arabic, hadith means saying or story, and kissa means blanket or cloak. The Hadith-e-Kissa was narrated by Sayyida Fatima alayhi salam, and the cloak belonged to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We've also learned that once the five Banjatan gather under the cloak, the Prophet declares that they are his confidants and supporters. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says in the Hadith-e-Kissa that they, the Ahlul Bayt, are from him and he is from them. And he asks Allah for their forgiveness and purification. Allah introduces the Panjathan to the angels and says he has created everything because of them, subhanallah. And Allah introduces the Panjathan through Sayyida Fatima alayhi salam, as she has a direct connection with all the Panjathan that are under the cloak. Now, Let us continue where we left off yesterday. Yesterday, we saw that the angel Gabriel asked Allah who the people under the cloak were, and that was when Allah introduced the Panjathan to the angels. After Allah introduces the Panjathan to the angels, the angel Jibra'il asks Allah if he can fly down to the earth to join the Ahlul Kissa, the people of the cloak, and be the sixth one under the cloak. Remember, at this point, there are five personalities under the cloak. I hope you remember all their names and the order in which they came under the cloak. فَقَالَ جِبْرَعِيلُ يَا رَبِّي أَتَعْذَنُ لِي أَنْ أَحْبِتَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ Gabriel said, O Lord, may I fly to the earth, لِيَكُونَ مَعَهُمْ سَادِسَ to be the sixth of them? فَقَالَ اللَّهُ نَعْمْ قَدْ أَذِنْتُ لَكَ Allah replied, Yes, you are given the permission. So, once Angel Jibra'il is granted permission by Allah to fly down to the earth, he does exactly that and he lands near the Ahlul Kissa, greets the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and seeks permission to enter the cloak. فَحَبَتَ الْعَمِينُ جِبْرَعِيلُ وَقَالَ أَسْسَلَامُ عَلَيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ Gabriel, the trusted, landed near them and said, Peace be on you, O Prophet of Allah. أَلِيُّ الْأَعْلَى يُقْرِيُكَ السَّلَامُ وَيَخُصُّكَ بِالتَّحِيَّةِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ The All-Highest conveys His peace on you and His greetings. Boys and girls, make a note here of how Angel Jibra'il first conveys his salams to the Prophet and salams from Allah before seeking permission to enter under the cloak. Angel Jibra'il then repeats what Allah had told all the angels about the creations. وَيَقُولُ لَكَ وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي And Allah had said to them, By my honor and glory, O my angels, O residents of my heavens. إِنِّي مَا خَلَقْتُ سَمَاعًا مَبْنِيًّا وَلَا أَرْضًا مَدْحِيًّا وَلَا قَمَرًا مُنِيرًا Verily, I have not created the erect sky, the stretched earth, the illuminated moon. وَلَا شَمْسًا مُضِيَّةً وَلَا فَلَكًا يَدُورٌ وَلَا بَحْرًا يَجْرِي وَلَا فُلْكًا يَسْرِي The bright sun, the rotating planets, the flowing seas, the sailing ships. إِلَّا لِأَجْلِكُمْ وَمَحَبَّتِكُمْ But for your sake and love. And it is at this point that Jibra'il brings the revelation of the ayah of purification, the ayah of Tathir. فَقَالَ لِيَبِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَوْحَى إِلَيْكُمْ يَقُولُ Remember, it is Bibi Fatima alayhi salam narrating this story. So she says that the angel Gabriel said to my father, Allah sends his revelations to you. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ Verily, Allah's desire is to keep you away from impurity and flaws. أَحْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُتَحِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا O people of the household, and keep you thoroughly purified. Let us recite a loud salawat on Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the Ahlul Bayt. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. So, boys and girls, this verse, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَحْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُتَحِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. This is the ayah Tathir, the ayah of purification, which is being revealed in praise of the Ahlul Bayt on the occasion of the event of the Qissa, which goes to show just how special this event was. Let's break the verse down into two parts so that we can understand it better. إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجس. Verily, Allah's desire is to keep you away from impurity and flaws. أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا. O people of the household, and keep you thoroughly purified. This verse of purification is a very special verse, and what makes it even more special is that it is Ayah 33 of Surah 33 of the Holy Quran. Before we move on to the next slide, can anybody tell me the name of Surah 33? And if you don't know it, then this is a good opportunity to open up the Holy Quran and look it up. Surah number 33 is Surah Al-Ahzab, and the Ayah of Tathir is Ayah 33 of this Surah. So 33, 33. As I mentioned earlier, boys and girls, this is an extremely important Ayah for all of us to remember, memorize, and understand. Through this Ayah, Allah has clearly showed us who the purified personalities are. And we also need to make sure that we respect and follow these personalities. So remember, 33, 33, Ayah 33 of Surah 33, which is Surah Al-Ahzab. Now, girls and boys, let us take a look at what we have learned today. Today we learned that the angel Gabriel greets the Prophet and his family and then asks for permission to enter the cloak. The angel Gabriel repeats that Allah would not have created the sky, the earth, the moon, the sun, the planets, the seas, or the sailing ships, and basically everything that exists had it not been for the people under the cloak. The angel Gabriel then brings the revelation of the Ayah of Tathir, the Ayah of purification, in the praise of the Ahlul Bayt. Ayah Tathir is Ayah 33, of Surah 33, and it states that Allah desires to keep away impurities from the Ahlul Bayt and purify them with a thorough purification. Boys and girls, that concludes this session for today of understanding Hadith-e-Qissa, and inshallah we will continue with understanding more of it again tomorrow. For now, we will continue with the rest of the children's Majlis program.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس صدق الله العظيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس صدق الله العلي العظيم.
Salaamu Alaikum, boys and girls, and welcome to the Children's Majlis program. Today, we're going to be understanding Surah An-Nas, Day 8. But before we start into further understanding Surah An-Nas, let us take a look at what we have learned so far. So, boys and girls, the recap that I'm going to do, these points, all of you should be somewhat familiar with them by now. So far we have learned that recitation of the Quran has five stages, which is reciting the surah, memorizing it, understanding it, applying the concepts to our daily lives, and teaching the surah and the concepts to other people. We've also learned that some of the benefits of reciting the Holy Quran include getting to a higher stage in Jannah and protecting our hearts from being punished. When it comes to Surah An-Nas, we've learned that recitation of Surah An-Nas provides many benefits, which include protection and relief. We have also learned that Surah An-Nas is Surah number 114 of the Holy Quran, and it is the last Surah of the Quran. And this Surah was revealed in the holy city of Makkah. In this Surah, we seek refuge with the Lord, King, and God of mankind from the slinking whisperer, who whispers evil into the heart of mankind and is from jinn and human. And finally, we learned that Allah is the provider of the ultimate refuge and protection. Now that we have finished with our recap of what we have learned so far, we can continue to further look at the key concepts in Surah An-Nas. Girls and boys, yesterday we had discussed how it is only Allah that can provide us with the best protection. He is our Lord, Rabb, our King, Malik, and our God, Ilah. Rabbin Nas, Malikin Nas, Ilahin Nas. Now, today, we are going to look at and try to understand what exactly are we seeking Allah's protection and refuge from? Who are we scared of? Who are we constantly worried about? In Surah An-Nas, it says that we seek refuge from min sharril waswasil khannas, from the evil of the slinking whisperer. Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas, who whispers evil into the hearts of mankind. Min al jinnati wan nas, and is from among jinn and mankind. Now, let us take a look at who this slinking whisperer is. The slinking whisperer referred to in Surah An-Nas is Shaitan or Satan. And slinking whisperer means that Shaitan whispers and hides. He does not come out in the open. Instead, he hides in the darkness and the shadows. And from there, he whispers into our hearts and he makes us think that the bad and evil thoughts that we have are ours. But really, they are satanic. And so, girls and boys, this is the slinking whisperer that Allah talks about in Surah An-Nas. And we have to remember always that because Shaitan is a slinking whisperer, because he hides in the darkness and the shadows, because he whispers into our hearts, he is a very dangerous and strong enemy. He is sly and cunning. And for these reasons, this is why we need the best protection against this enemy. We need the ultimate refuge. We need Allah. Now, I'm going to give you a little homework for today. Don't worry, the homework is very simple, and in fact, it is very interesting and will make for some good discussion and conversation. Starting from today, I would like you to be very observant and see if you sense any whisperings of the slinking whisperer. Look out for thoughts that tell you to do something which is not right. These can be thoughts you have about not helping around the house with your chores, speaking rudely to your parents or anyone else really, being mean to other kids, not sharing, not caring, thoughts that tell you to continue playing on your iPad or watch TV instead of going to pray on time. Any thoughts really that you have that are not good, and thoughts that keep coming back again and again. Let us take a look at what we have learned today. Today, we learned that in this surah, Surah An-Nas, we are seeking refuge from the slinking whisperer. The slinking whisperer is Satan, or Shaitan. Shaitan makes us think that the evil thoughts that we have are ours. And from today, we are going to observe if we sense any whispers of Shaitan. So boys and girls, this concludes our discussion about Surah An-Nas for today. Tomorrow, we will start with looking at how Shaitan whispers evil thoughts into our hearts.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome to the Children's Majalis program. This is the 8th night day of Muharram Majalis program. Today we are going to talk about Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam. Hazrat Abbas's father is Imam Ali alayhi salam. His mother is Fatima Kailabiyya, famously known as Ummul Banin. Hazrat Abbas had three other brothers, Abdullah, Ja'far, Uthman. He was born on 4th of Shaban, 26 after Hijrah. He married a lady called Lubaba, and they had three sons, Fadl, Muhammad, and Ubaidullah. And of course, Hazrat Abbas's other siblings are Imam Hassan alayhi salam, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam, and Sayyida Umm Kulthum alayhi salam. Hazrat Abbas's name is always associated with a flag called an alam in Arabic. In Arab warfare, every army used to have a flag. The flag would be given to the bravest man in the army, who would also be the commander-in-chief. What does the alam flag represent? A flag or an alam represents the values of the country it stands for. In the system of Arab warfare, the one who carried the alam had a special honor. The alam bearer was the commander of the army who guided those who fought. The alam of Islam was carried by Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam in Karbala. The alam of Hazrat Abbas is a symbol for the uncompromising cause of right and justice. In easy words, it is a symbol of truth. What do the alams we carry in Muharram represent? By raising hundreds and thousands of alams, we are symbolically saying to Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam that although the Yazid's army killed him, we will carry on the message and keep the cause of Islam alive. Now you usually see alams have a hand on top of them. What does the hand on top of the alam represent? The hand on top of the alam represents the Ahlul Kisa, the Panjatan. When we know the answer to something, we usually put up our hand. The alam signifies that Islam has the answer to everything. What else does the hand on top of the alam represent? Do you remember this picture? Yes. It represents giving bayah. We give our hands in bayah in allegiance to Allah, His Prophet, and His Ahlul Bayt. And of course, our present Imam, Imam Mahdi, ajallallahu ta'ala faraja. This is a very common question as well. Why do we cover the alam we carry with fabric? When the flag of Islam carried by Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam fell in Karbala, physically, it was not raised again. Symbolically, it was carried by the ladies of the Ahlul Bayt as they were paraded through the streets of Kufa and Sham. In the memory of the bravery of the ladies, the alams we carry today are decorated with clothes. Let's look at some of the titles of Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam. Abu al-Fadl Abbas, father of virtue, Abu al-Qasim, father of Qasim. Abu Qurba, the owner of the skin of water. Shahanshah Wafa, Sultan of loyalty. Qamr Bani Hashim, moon of the Hashemites. Alamdar, flag bearer. Saqqa, one who fetches water. Babul Hawaij, the door to fulfilling needs. Now let's look at some of the qualities of Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam. He was brave, was honest, loyal, obedient, trustworthy, caring. He was a true friend, and he was extremely kind. The night before Ashura arrives. On the day of Ashura, the children were crying out loud, Al-Atash, Al-Atash, thirst, thirst. Sayyida Sakina alayha salam came up to Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam and pleaded, Uncle Abbas, please bring me some water. The thirst is killing us. Imam Hussein alayhi salam brought a mashk to Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam and asked him to bring back some water. With the alam in one hand and the mashk tied to it and a sword in the other hand, Hazrat Abbas set out to get water for the children. The army of Yazid knew of the valor and bravery of Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam, and they all covered behind each other. And those who dared to come forward were instantly killed. The soldiers fled in disarray. Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam got to the river Furat and filled the water bag and got on his horse, intending to get the water to the children as soon as possible. From a hill, the children watched the alam coming and their hopes rose. The enemy too saw that Abbas had the water and was going towards the camp. One of the soldiers snuck behind a tree and attacked his right arm. Hazrat Abbas held on to the water bag and the alam with his left hand. Another soldier struck his left arm with a sword. Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam held the alam and the water bag with his teeth. His only aim was to get the water to the children, and he started galloping towards the camp. Just then, an arrow pierced the water bag, and all the water gushed out, spilling on the sand. Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam fell off his horse onto the ground and called out, Oh my master, oh my master, my salams to you. The alam with an empty water bag tied to it fell to the ground. Imam Hussein alayhi salam ran to where the voice was coming from. He was blinded by the tears in his eyes. His back felt as though it was broken. When he got to where Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam had fallen, he knelt down and lifted Hazrat Abbas's head onto his lap. Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam said with a feeble voice, My master, when I was born, you were the first person I saw. My last wish is that I see your face before I die. But my eye is pierced with an arrow. Please clean my other eye of the blood so I may see you for the last time. And master, master, please do not carry my body to the camp, because I'm so ashamed to face Sakina and the other children for having returned empty-handed without water. Imam Hussein alayhi salam wept as he said, Abbas, I shall fulfill your wishes, but I too have a wish. Since childhood, you have always called me your master. For once, at least call me brother. As the dying brother gazed into the eyes of Imam, he said before closing his eyes to death, My brother, my brother. Ya Abbas, Ya Abbas, Ya Abbas, Ya Abbas. Let's look at some of the lessons we learned from Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam. To be brave, to always be honest, to be loyal to our Imam, to be obedient to Allah, our Imam, and our parents. To be trustworthy, to be caring, to be a true friend the way he was to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and to be kind. Thank you for attending the Children's Majalis program. Please continue the program with Matam. Every day is Ashura, every land is Karbala.
Where is my Abbas? Where is my Abbas? Where has my Abbas gone? Where has my Abbas gone? Where has my Abbas gone? Where has my Abbas gone?
Oh, Abbas, you were my uncle. Oh Abbas, you were my brother. Oh Abbas, you were my son. Like you there was no other. You went to search for water. You searched so far and wide. You went for your brother's daughter. In your search for her you died.
Where has my Abbas gone? Where has my Abbas gone? Where has my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone?
You hear the thirsty children, you hear them and you hurt. Their hopes are slowly dimming, so you ride out to Furat. Your brother was your master, before him you'd never drink. To Furat you rode much faster, for Ruqayya you only think.
Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone?
The thirst, how it pains them, you hear it in your mind. Al-Atash, Uncle Abbas, why were they so unkind? Your mashk is full of water, you turn to the camp of Hussein. You're bringing this for his daughter, but you never see her again.
Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my Abbas gone? Where's my
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليك يا رسول الله السلام عليك يا فريدة الكبرى السلام عليك يا فاطمة الزهرة السلام عليك يا علي المرتضى السلام عليك يا حسن البدر السلام عليك يا حسين الشهيد السلام عليك يا علي الزين العابدين ومحمد الباكر وجعفر الصادق وموسى القادم وعلي رضا ومحمد في وليناتي والحسن العسكري رحمة الله وبركاته السلام عليك يا سابع الزي والزمان ألمان 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 بالفن الزمان السلام عليك يا شريك القرآن وقابة الإيمان وإمامنا وإمامنا الإنس والجاز أجد الله تعالى فرجه وصاح الله تعالى فرجه وذكور رحمة الله بركاته الله
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I begin in the name of Allah, who is most kind and most merciful. Craft time. Today, we will be making a Muharram flag. You will need a pair of scissors, a glue stick, markers and a pencil, craft stick, construction paper, one black and one any other color, and stickers. Remember that you can pause this video at any time while you work on the craft. Step 1. Draw any shape you like on the colored construction paper. For this video, we have used a star. Cut out the shape you have drawn and be careful when using your scissors. Step 2. Write Ya Abbas on the shape you have cut. You can write it in Arabic or English. Cut out a rectangle from the black construction paper. It should be bigger than the shape. Step 3. Glue the shape on top of the black rectangle that you have cut out. Step 4. Turn your paper over. Remember, the shape should be underneath. Using your glue stick, apply glue on the edge of the black paper. Put the stick on the glued area. If you are using a round stick, then fold the paper over to hold it in place. And if you are using a flat stick, then you don't have to do this. Step 5. You can put some stickers if you want. Once done, your flag should look like this. You can keep your flag along with the alam you have made before, or where you will be listening to the Majlis.